did you know that Exa Parkour is able to extract the content of the Outlook? Yes, it is true. In today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to extract the content of the Excel attachments from my Outlook. Okay, let's assume I received 3 templates from different sources and I need to merge the content of the Excel files without saving them on my device. So I go to the Data tab, hit Get Data, and this time I'm going to choose from Online Services and from there, from Microsoft Exchange Online. You need to have a Microsoft account to use this option in Parkour. If you're not signed in, then you need to sign into your Microsoft account. If you have your email signed in, then you need to just simply type your email address and hit OK. From there, the Query Navigator will read the content of your Outlook. Since I'm looking for emails I just received, I'm going to choose the mail type and hit Transform Data. In the Query window, I can see a lot of objects and attributes related to my Outlook, but I will need only just 2 columns. I go to the Choose Columns, and from the following options, I'm going to choose Folder Path and Attachment. Hit OK. Since I know that those emails are in my inbox, from the Folder Path, I'm going to select Inbox. Then I can expand the attributes of the actual attachment. I click on the double arrow, and from there, what I need is the name, extension, and attachment content. I hit OK, and as you see, the query read the name of the files as well as it extracted the actual file content. And now I'm going to extract the content of the Excel files. I go to the Add Column tab, I hit Custom Column, and I'm going to use a simple AND function. I'm going to name my column as Excel Content, and the function we learned today is the Excel.Workbook. My value is going to be the Attachment Content column. I hit OK, and the query will list out the different type of objects saved in the different Excel files in my Outlook. Now I click on the double arrow, and from there, I'm going to choose only the data, item, and kind. Hit OK. Then I'm going to scroll to the right a little bit. And in the kind column, I can see the different type of objects saved in the Excel files in my Outlook attachment. Let's say this time I want to merge tables from this template. So I'm going to select table. And from the item column, I'm going to select one table since I have multiple tables in my Excel files, but I want to merge the same tables. Let's say mileage record. Hit OK. And now I can extract the actual content of the Excel tables in my Outlook. If I select the data column and one of the item, then you can see that what type of tables are saved there and what are the values in those tables. But before we would extract the content, I'm going to select the data and the name column, right click, hit remove other columns, and then I click on the double arrow under the data column. It will list out me the available columns in the actual Excel tables. I'm not going to use the prefix this time. I need all the columns, and then I just simply hit OK. And here we go. As you see, the Power Query was able to read the content of the Excel files from my Outlook attachment. If you wish, you can do additional transformation to your data, but this time I'm going to just simply load as a table. I hit close and load. I open up the query pane, right click, load to, select table, existing worksheet. I'm going to select the A1 and hit OK. And it's done. The Power Query was able to read and extract the data from my Microsoft Outlook without saving any file on my device.